we have derived the differential form of energy balance equation starting from total energy and expressed in terms of temperature. Also closed it using the Fourier's law of heat conduction, simplified it, and now it is time to look at the applications. Let us look at simple applications. One is of course, the main application is to find out the temperature profile. We are going to find out the temperature profile in a slab and then extend that to a furnace wall and then in a planar cuvette flow. So, let us start with the first application, which is heat conduction in a slab. What we have is a slab like this, and then the two surfaces are maintained at two different temperatures, let us say T naught and then TL. The thickness of the slab is L, and what is that we are interested in? What is the temperature profile across the thickness of the slab? How temperature varies with the thickness of the slab? We will consider the case where this surface is at a higher temperature, this surface is at a lower temperature, and so heat flows, the heat flows from higher temperature to a lower temperature along the positive x axis and takes place by conduction. We will consider steady state condition, and we are going to consider only one dimensional heat transfer, and that is why it says steady state one dimensional heat conduction. So, we will start with an assumption that the thermal conductivity is a constant, meaning that it does not vary with temperature. Now, we have seen different simplifications of the energy balance equation. So, now we should take the form which is applicable for solids, because we are considering a solid slab material, and then so the energy balance for solids was shown to be this form. In fact, we had a capital DT by DT, the substantial derivative on the left hand side. Because it is a stationary solid, the convection term dropped out and we are left with only the partial derivative of temperature on the left hand side, and of course, rho Cp. Right hand side, we have the net heat flow term due to conduction. Now, this gets further simplified because it is steady state. So, the left hand side becomes 0, because it is one dimensional, these two terms become 0, and we are left only with the temperature variation along the x direction. Okay, this is the x direction, and only this term remains. So, we get the equation d square t by d x square equal to 0, which is a second order ordinary differential equation. We require two boundary conditions to solve this second order ODE, and the temperatures are specified at both ends of the slab, and those are the boundary conditions. At x equal to 0, this x equal to 0, the left hand, the left surface of the slab. So, the temperature is T equal to T naught at x equal to 0, and then at the right surface, the temperature is T L and x equal to L. So, we know the temperatures at both the surfaces, x equal to 0, x equal to L, and this is T naught, this is T L. So, those serve as the boundary conditions. So, let us summarize them here. The energy balance has finally simplified to just a simple second order ordinary differential equation with the right hand side 0. Does not even look like energy balance now, okay. But we know the physics behind it, we know how we arrived at that particular equation, and these are the boundary conditions which I have discussed. So, we integrate once, it becomes dt by dx is equal to c 1, integrate once again, we get t is equal to c 1 x plus c 2, and we need to evaluate the two constants. We will use both the boundary conditions. At x equal to 0, t is equal to t naught. So, if we substitute in this equation, we get c 2 is equal to t naught. Let us use the second boundary condition, t is equal to t l at x equal to l. So, once again substitute in this equation, left hand side we have t l and x is equal to l, and we know that c 2 is t naught. So, if you rearrange, we get the constant c 1 as t l minus t naught by l. So, let us substitute both the constants in this equation, and we get t is equal to t l minus t naught by l into x plus t naught, which gives the temperature profile across the thickness of the slab. At x equal to 0, we have t naught, and x equal to l, we get t l, and that is a temperature profile shown here. This is t naught and this is t l, and it varies linearly. We can also express this in the dimensionless form. So, we have t on the left hand side, let us bring t naught to the left hand side. So, we have t minus t naught, then divide by t l minus t naught. So, this becomes the dimensionless temperature. Right hand side, we have x by l. So, we can express the temperature profile in this dimensionless form as well. And let us evaluate the heat flux. Heat flux is given by minus k dt by dx, and we have seen here dt by dx, that is a temperature gradient or the slope of the temperature profile is c 1. So, minus k, let us substitute for c 1, which is t l minus t naught by l, and so you get k t naught minus t l by l. What do we observe? The heat flux is a constant, because L is a constant, the end temperatures are constant, we assume the thermal conductivity to be constant. So, all variables here are constant, the heat flux is just a constant, it does not vary. Throughout the thickness of the slab, you have only one heat flux value, which is given by k T naught minus T L by L. We should also know that in the previous slide, we have discussed all the physics, and what we discussed in this slide is just pure maths. At this stage, the physics ends and then the maths starts. So, that should also be kept in mind, so that we clearly understand what is the physics of the problem, what is the maths of the problem. If we carefully recall our discussion on the previous two slides, many steps, many words also I would say, would be same as what we discussed earlier for the case of planar cuvette flow. So, let us now discuss the analogy between momentum and heat transport by using the two examples. One is this planar cuvette flow, and then the other one is the present example of heat conduction in a slab. Let us see how they are very much analogous. Okay, so, left hand side we have velocity profile in a planar cuvette flow, the flow between two parallel plates, the bottom plate fixed, the top plate set in motion. Right hand side we have temperature profile in a slab, we have a slab, the left and right surfaces are maintained at two different temperatures. So, here two different velocities, 0 and then velocity of the plate. Here we have two different temperatures. What is the governing equation? The governing equation just becomes d squared v x by d y squared equal to 0. What is the governing equation here? It just became d squared t by d x squared equal to 0. What are the boundary conditions for the case of planar curved flow? At y equal to 0, v x equal to 0, and at y equal to h, v x equal to v p, the two velocities. Right hand side, x equal to 0, t equal to t naught, x equal to l, t equal to t l. Of course, the direction is different. Here it is along the y axis, here it is along the x axis. Now, how do we solve? So, the physics of the problem NCR, the governing equation and the boundary conditions. Now, we start solving them. The left hand side we integrate once, we get dvx by dy is equal to c1. Right hand side integrate once, we get dt by dx is equal to c1, a constant. Integrate again the left hand side, we get vx is equal to c1y plus c2. Right hand side once again integrate, we get t is equal to c1x plus c2. We evaluate the two constants, we use the boundary condition. The first boundary condition at the bottom plate and find c2 equal to 0. Here once again we use the boundary condition at the left surface and find out the constant c2 as t0. Next we use the second boundary condition, which is velocity at the top plate, and find the constant as Vp by h. Here again we use the boundary condition in terms of temperature at the right surface and find out the constant C1. Substitute the constants and then get the expression for the velocity profile. Substitute the constants, get the expression for the temperature profile. At this stage they may look different, but moment we express in terms of dimensionless form, they become very much analogous. The dimensionless velocity on the left hand side, the dimensionless distance on the right hand side. Here again dimensionless temperature on the left hand side, dimensionless distance on the right hand side, and both the profiles are linear. We use the arrow mark to show velocity, but for temperature it is a scalar, so we do not use the arrow mark. And in both the cases we should know that the term which remained in the conservation equation was due to molecular transport. In the case of fluid flow, it was the molecular transport of momentum, and in the case of slab, it is the molecular transport of heat. Okay. So, only those terms remained, and the solution, procedure, the profile, all are very much analogous. What is the reason? We discussed the previous lecture that momentum and heat transport are mathematically analogous when it is one dimensional case. Because in these cases, because we are discussing one dimensional case, both momentum and heat transport are mathematically analogous.